All right, sorry for the audio at the beginning there. I forgot to wear my little mic here. So we're just making a couple of tiny washers. I didn't have any small enough. So that should work. And so should that one. Okay, we're gonna give it a shot. Just a tiny weld there and a tiny weld on this nut. Kind of build it up a little bit. And we'll see how she goes. And I'm gonna stop talking, I'm gonna set my timer, and we're gonna knock these out real quick. Now what the hell? Well, okay. All right, guys, so the welding didn't quite go as planned. I cannot get a good ground. So we are going to try to set this up in a different way and get those broken screws out with an end mill. Put the parts back with the rest of his vise. I'm always scared to death I'm gonna lose something. All right, so I wonder if we're gonna have enough room here to get the spindle in. That's gonna be the trick. See if this is even going to be possible. And it's not looking good. Without an extremely long 1/8 inch end mill, it is not looking good. No, I don't think so. Well, maybe. We might be able to pull this off. Of course, we got to be extremely careful here. Well, that's 1/8 by 1/8. Not very long. I want to try to end mill it flat and then center drill it and then left hand drill bit to get it out if we can. Those are a number 1032. We don't want to go higher than our tap drill, which is a number 21. Number 21 is 0.159. All right, so those are exactly 2.5. Yes, 2.5 inch long. So that's 1.25 inches. 1.25 inches will be our center Y. All right, now the height is gonna be 5/8. So from the bottom to the center of the hole is going to be 1/2 of 5/8, so 5/16. So we gotta come out here and touch it. Assuming that's not low, then we'll go to the other side. Okay. Give her a flick. Making sure we're not hitting the vise on the spindle. We don't want anything crazy to happen, or I'll be buying a very expensive vise. Okay, 0x, try it again. Okay, now we're 250 in on the X. We need to go 312 and a half. So 72 and a half. Watch your frickin' math. Now, the bolt spacing is 1 5/8. So we're gonna go half of that, which is 812 and a half on X. And we should be directly centered over that hole. And we've got clearance, barely. Man, I can't see anything. I need one of those lights on my milling machine. So what is that, 0.625 minus 0.562? That makes no sense. 0.625 minus 0.562, 63 thou. We move over 63, are we going to be in the middle of this? Let me find out. Are we going to have room is the better question. Oh my gosh. Not in the center there either. That looks more centered to me, but what the heck do I know? Are we centered this way? Yeah. Let's give her a whirl. All right, so make sure we're not gonna hit that spindle. Looking good, and we'll move the tool speed back up to 100. And we'll set our RPMs. Give it a shot. Oh, shoot. Yeah, no wonder I couldn't weld it. That's JB weld. So, need to tap that. See where my tap guide is. Somewhere in here. .1032 tap. I don't know if I have any spiral fluted ones, but I'm gonna look real quick. Feel free to hang out and wait. Well, you don't have much of a choice, do you? Let me get my cutting fluid off the shaper over here. Oh yeah. There we go. What the f- I'm having a terrible day. Terrible day. Hold that thought. Okay, sorry. Gotta set another timer. I got some jaws out of the heat treat oven there. So my best guess is that somebody stripped these screws out and then they tried to JB weld them in place. Or just created an entire screw out of JB weld, which sounds insane, but that is why I couldn't get a weld to stick on there. That was not cast iron, that was not steel that I was milling. It looked like plastic or JB weld. Some kind of a epoxy acrylic material. So that's my guess at least. Wow, I get super sidetracked, I'm sorry. I completely forgot what I was working on. Well, I've completely forgot I was making a video is what I mean. I'll bring you back when I get the jaws on, and I'll be milling them together. We'll put the whole vise together, indicate it. And I'll bring you back. I'm gonna work on the lathe for a minute. So we gotta mount this vise here somehow. Use a couple toe clamps. Going high over here. Where's my little hammer? Still going high. You all just like to watch me struggle severely, don't you? That is what I like to do. Always a struggling. Have to get us some longer toe clamps here. You know, the customer didn't know this vise has been completely modified. It's not his fault. These are my least favorite kinds. You know, I've got my measurements that I already know because I've made up thousands of these little sets for the 2.5 inch. And let's say if he didn't send me this vise and I mailed him to him, he would think that's wrong because, I mean, they're way off on each side. Either this is a factory defect that I've never seen before, or this vise has been modified. And I'm going with the modified, seeing as how the screws were broke, there was JB welding the holes. I think it's a safe bet. I'm not going to be able to reach that from here. There we go. We'll do it on this side and keep this one here way low on that side. Low on that side again. Three and a half. And 2.5. Yep, we're within a half a thou again, which is 5/10 for all you uninitiated. All right. Change our end mill here. put me some glasses on. Oh no. There goes an end mill. Alright guys, we got the sides milled off. Even those up really nicely. And also the tops flattened. So now we gotta braze this up. We gotta pull that pin out and braze this up. Thank you. All right, guys, we put it in our sand to let it cool real slow, and I'll bring you back in a few hours when we pull that out, and we'll get the crack cleaned up, and this vise will be ready to go. All right, guys, didn't get the best finish on it. We got a couple little voids, but the crack is fixed. It does look like it blended in really well. We didn't do the top side. I was asked to just get it to stick, and that's it. So we got her to stick. We're gonna put this vise back together, heat treat those jaws, and get it sent back to the customer. And I just wanna thank you guys for watching. And if you like this kind of content, you like the video, you want to see more, just subscribe, share the video to your friends, share it to your groups that you're in. It would really help out a lot.